So if you watched my last video, you probably have a bit of an idea now about what sort of brush you want to use for water-fed pole. But now you've got to decide what sort of jets you want into it. So in today's video, I'm going to be looking at the three main types of jets for water-fed pole brushes. So every company has their own way of fitting their jets into the brushes, so, and there's absolutely loads to choose from. It might be a bit confusing when you first start which ones to go for and why. So today I'm going to categorise them into three categories, and we'll have a look at each of the different categories. We'll explain what they do and how they work and what sort of glass you should be using them on. So I've got a selection here. The ones at the back row here are they call capsule jets from Gardner. I've got these ones from Streamline. These ones are actually fan jets from Streamline, but I've got a selection of others there. Not sure what those are from. These are the older fan jets from Gardner. I think they're phasing those out pretty much now because they were breaking quite often and didn't last very long. And the other thing that we'll be looking at is rinse bars, which is this yellow, this red bar across the top of the brush. So the three categories are pencil jets, fan jets, and rinse bars. Now, I'll use the Gardner ones as a demonstration because I've got a complete set here of all the different types. So to start off with the pencil jets. The pencil jets have got a very small round hole in them. This allows the water to come out in a pinpoint and a pencil, basically. They get different size jets. The blue ones are 1.4 millimeters. The black ones are 2 millimeters. And I think the green ones are 3 millimeters. These are very useful when you want to be a bit more accurate with your water, where you want it to go on the windows. Say if you've got vents across the top, or you're worried about it hitting the surround of the window, you can be very accurate with the pencil jets. Now, when would you use each one? Pencil jets are pretty good on, especially on hydrophilic glass, where the water sheets down. They're particularly good on those, and as I said, you can be very accurate with them. Now the 1.4 millimeter ones, you'd probably use these mostly if you were trying to conserve water a bit. To me, they're a little bit thin. If you have the water turned up quite high, it almost works like a pressure washer and shoots the water out of the jets, and which I don't find very good. You have to have the water flow a bit lower. Now I like a lot of water on the glass, so I tend to put four jets when I'm using them into my brush, my 35 centimeter brush. So I'll tend to use four of the black 2 millimeter ones. This gives you quite a high flow of water. Again, you can be very accurate with it. And with the hydrophilic glass where it sheets down, these give a really nice covering of water all the way across, and it will all sheet down nicely. Now, if you want loads of water on the glass, you can use the 3 millimeter ones. If you've got just a narrow brush and you still want a lot of water, maybe use the 3 millimeter ones on that. With the wider brush, I found it a bit too much using the 3 millimeter. Did use a lot of water, which is great because it speeds up your rinsing, but you needed to turn the pressure up quite high to make sure it went out far enough from the brush. The fan jets, which are these are fan jets as well, and so are these. So with the fan jets, you tend to get a different degree of spray depending on which ones you get. The grey ones are 100 degree, so they come out at quite a wide fan, and the red ones are 50 degree, so they come out at a narrower fan. So I really like these. They work really well. They get a nice even spray across the brush. And they're better on hydrophobic glass, where when you rinse down, it doesn't sheet so well, it beads on the glass. So you have to rinse right down the glass using it almost like a water squeegee in a way, bringing all that dirt down as you rinse, but it brings a nice even spray across the whole of the brush. The downside about using these, especially with the grey ones, which I've got on this brush here, is because the jet is so wide, sometimes it does hit the bristles in the middle of the brush. So what I've done is I've just taken a pair of pliers and pulled out some of the middle bristles so it's less likely to hit the brush. You don't really notice it with the scrubbing power, I've noticed no difference by that, but the water was hitting the bristles and ruining the jet. Now the third category is the rinse bar. Now these come in various different sizes. This one is for the 35cm brush from Gardner. And the way it fits is it just goes under the two screws that the brush stock fits on. So this has got a series of tiny little holes along it. Gardner do two different sorts. They do one with double the amount of holes to the other. That gives you more of a level flow all the way across, but it does use more water. So when you use these, they do a nice stream of water constantly all the way across the brush. So it's almost again like a squeegee when you're on the glass. You bring it down and it comes down with it in a nice constant flow. As I said, these also are very good on hydrophobic glass, where the glass doesn't sheet down, it streams down, it beads, and then that way you can fetch all the beads down all together and get a nice consistent clean with that, getting all the dirty water off. So how do you fit them? Well, the streamlined ones I've got here are really good. I'll show you on this narrow brush. So all you do, streamlined ones, is you twist them, push them into the brush and twist, and that's all there is to it. Again, push and twist, and then you can choose which one of your fittings you want. These, again, just push into the John Guest fitting and then just connect onto your pole hose. So those are really simple to fit. Whether you use it with two jets, I've got two fan jets in here and two pencil jets, or whether you use it with four jets, I've got four pencil jets in here and I've got a four-way John Guest fitting from Streamline on there. Now the Gardner ones are also really easy. The way they work is you can get a little tool from Gardner. The jets fit inside the tool, and then if I put them in the right way, the jets fit inside the tool, you just push them into the brush and twist, and that's all there is to it. It's that simple. Once you've fitted your jets into your brush, again, all you need to do is with your hose kit, with a little John Guest fitting, just push in, and it's literally that easy. So again, with this one, at the moment I've got the four grey 100 degree fan jets on that, giving it a nice constant spray, but then you can change it, and I've got a four-way John Guest splitter on here as well. Now with the rinse bars, these come in two categories really. This one is what they call an over-the-top rinse bar, and that fits in behind the brush stock with two screws, and what that does, it gives you a fan of water or a jet of water all the way across the top of the brush, forming a nice curtain as you come down the window, and that, like I said, misses the bristles on the top, or just about catches the bristles on the top, so you can do that. The other way that they work is, this is a Ionix one, is the rinse bar is actually in the middle of the brush. The middle's completely void of this one of bristles, so you're not going to catch any bristles, which is quite nice with that. But the only thing I don't like about this one is the rinse bar is probably only 6 inches wide, so it is a bit of a narrow rinse bar, but all the same, it does give a nice even flow all the way across. Some people don't like these because they say if you're rinsing on the glass, then the last thing that touches it is the bristles. With these, if you rinse on the glass, the last thing that touches it is the water going across the top. So that's giving you a bit of a rough idea about the different types of rinse bars, fan jets and pencil jets, why you'd use each one and where you'd use each one. So I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.